right. Well, this is something you haven't seen in a while, and actually monthly favorites. Simply because lately I don't really have favorites or enough each month to do a monthly video like I used to, so I've kind of been doing them in seasons. Well, I feel like I have a pretty decent list, so here we go. Hey everyone, this is Rose, and welcome to my random channel. This is going to be my January 2017 favorites. I'm just completely shocked that I'm actually uploading something somewhat on time. This is going to be, there's actually a pretty decent array of makeup products. Things that you guys might actually find interesting. Now, the way that I do my favorites videos now, I actually do them by sections with, like, headers. So, you know, if you, don't feel like hearing about a section, you just fast forward. I don't know if you guys know, but if you watch YouTube on your phone, if you tap like the right side of the screen twice, like boop boop, really fast, it fast forwards at 10 seconds. I don't see why not. It wouldn't work on a computer screen with your mouse. And so if you do it on the left side, boop boop, it rewinds at 10 seconds. So, but anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and get started. And the first thing that I'm going to talk about, just got an email, is a eyeshadow that's actually by a company that's more well known for their nail polishes. If you're not aware of Julep, I will link my playlist down below. This is actually one of their eyeshadows that I was reacquainted with recently. It's their Dial Up Your Glam Multidimensional Orbital Eyeshadow in Eclipse. It's this beautiful, domed eyeshadow where the glitter is actually not just like the overlay. It actually goes through the whole thing because I've used this a few times actually and the glitter is still there. But that's a finger swatch. And then here is the actual shadow. But this just looks really beautiful on the eyes. The glitter stands out, but it's not annoying, and it doesn't get all over your face. Julep actually does a pretty good job with their makeup, so it's a monthly subscription program that you can, of course, shop with at any time. If you're interested in joining, I can put that link down below, but I also will link my playlist in case you're interested in learning more about the program. Okay, the next thing I'm going to talk about is another eyeshadow company. Well, actually, it's a makeup company. It's pretty darn popular. ColourPop. I was just introduced to them, like, I think it was shortly before Christmas. Just because I'm not really a huge fan of cream or like, well, creamy eyeshadows, but these actually have a decent texture that work awesome when you use your finger or synthetic eye brushes. But yeah, but these are the Super Shock Shadows. The packaging does get really dirty if you don't take care of it because it's white. But this is the color Dare, and that's Dare, and the consistency is really strange because it's not like creamy per se, but as you can see, you know, my finger leaves like a imprint, like it's cushioned. You do have to make sure you do close these very tight, otherwise they will dry out. But there's a finger swatch, and then I'll put this next to that Julep one. But yeah, that's just a single swipe. Very beautiful color. The colors that have actual glitter in them, the pigmentation is just beautiful. This is DGAF, kind of like my personal philosophy on life. And then this is what it looks like in the pan. Very pretty. It's like a beautiful, like rose gold almost, that has like yellow and green glitters in them. I have Partridge, which is basically like that famous duochrome greenish brown shade. I'm already swatching it and I haven't even showed you what it looks like. Very pretty. There it is on my thumb, and I'll just do this right up there. And I don't know, I didn't really demonstrate, but I basically did just a single thumb swipe. Look at that pigmentation. Like, these are so pigmented that you don't have to use a base underneath them. This last one is gorgeous. It's Envy. And it's basically like a blackish purple with a crap ton of purple glitter in it. And I guess I'm going to use my pinky. Oh no, my nail just went into it. Maybe I can lay it. Oh, there we go. Just laid it back down. But that's it on my finger. With my ridiculously long pinky nail. And I'm just going to put this like right above all of them. And as you can see, and God, I do the most awkward swatches, you guys. But very pretty. Okay, the next thing I absolutely use anyway underneath all my eyeshadows, including those, but I was reintroduced to the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion. I believe one of the best primer potions that you can use. Do you see the type of eye makeup that I have, which I know is pretty excessive, but just to give you an idea, it's almost 9 p.m. My makeup has been done since 7 a.m., so it's been 13 hours. I have absolutely no creasing going on, and I am extremely oily. This stuff is the best. And actually, I do like this packaging over the old school genie bottle packaging that it used to have. Okay, and the next thing I actually don't have to show because I just showed it in my empties video, but I'll insert a picture. It's a really good drugstore makeup setting spray by Wet n Wild, the Photo Focus face spray. I think it works great. Of course, it's not on the same level as, like, to me so far, I think the Scandinavia spray, even though it's exactly like Urban Decay, seems to work the best. It's not quite as good as that, but it's pretty darn close. So if you're looking for a cheap alternative, that is if they haven't discontinued it yet, then try the Wet n Wild Photo Focus face setting spray or makeup setting spray. I'm actually really curious about the foundation. I may be trying that soon. The next day I actually showed forever ago in a favorites video because I got this December of 2015, I think it was, when I was in Washington, D.C. I will be back in D.C. next week. This is the Kiko Milano lipstick in the color number 901, which I'll have to look up what the name is. But Kiko Cosmetics is a great, affordable makeup line. This lipstick is my typical color, a nice nude, has a yummy vanilla scent that's very reminiscent of MAC lipsticks. It's the color that I'm wearing right now. And then here's a swatch on my hand, just very buttery, very pigmented. I can sometimes put this on without wearing a chapstick and it just goes on beautifully. And this was really cheap. The last time I checked, which has me a little bit worried, the cosmetics on the Kiko Milano or cosmetic website, everything was really discounted. Everything that I talk about, I'll link down below. I remember the lipsticks and some of the lip glosses were like $1 and $2. So I hope to God it doesn't mean that the line's like. The next thing isn't like makeup directly, but it's connected with it. I did a video on it recently, the Beautylish Lucky Bag, which I can link below, and I can also put in a card. It's basically like a, not even yearly subscription, it's something you can only buy once a year. You can pre-order it in the last week of December. It's kind of like a gamble. You pay between $75 to $150, which I know sounds crazy, but it's so worth it. And you basically get a mystery box of goodies. If you pay for the $75 bag, lucky bag, you get at least $150 worth of stuff. My bag was actually worth $202. And it's all stuff that's on the Beautylish website, which Beautylish has an awesome array of products from really affordable to really high-end. Now, if you buy the $150 bag, that guarantees you like at least $300 worth of stuff. So I definitely will be taking advantage of it next year. It ties in with the next product, which is an item that I got in that. And as you can tell, this has been heavily used. This is a Wayne Goss brush. I think this is one of his more expensive brushes. This brush is his 00 brush. It retails for $85. But this brush is on a whole nother level. Like, if I win the lottery or something, I'm just gonna buy all his makeup brushes because judging by this one, they're phenomenal. They're handmade. It takes like 20 artisans to make each brush, and so many hours goes into each one. The handle is a Japanese wood. And they're supposed to be cruelty-free because they're made of animal hair. This is made of goat. But this is basically the brush that I've been using to put on my bronzer and my blush and sometimes my highlighter, and it works beautifully. I don't know if I should, like, close this up because the actual brush is filthy. But yes, I love this thing, and as soon as I can afford it, I will be buying more of his brushes. The next thing I was just reminded of in my last influencer, why I love influencer video, just because I initially tested it when I first got the box forever ago and then kind of set it aside. But this is a great, not the best I would say, but it's a great waterproof waterline black eyeliner that's very pigmented from the drugstore. It's the Rimmel Scandal Eyes Waterproof Caudal Eyeliner. And then this is what the packaging looks like. They kind of show you just how creamy it is. I'm going to try to demonstrate this live. Barely any pressure. But do you see that? How dark that is? The first thing I'm going to show you, I swear, is something that my friends and family probably think that I live in, because I basically do. I wear this shirt sometimes twice in a week. But this is an old, it's over a year old. So I don't know if Forever 21 still make these, but I absolutely need to go to the store and see and buy more. I remember when I bought this, I tried on a few other color patterns and I wasn't really that fond of them. But this is one of their flannel plaid shirts. The most comfortable I've slept in this thing. I absolutely love this shirt and have to get more. It has a snap closure with a couple of pockets on the chest area. I basically live in the shirt. And the last thing I have in the fashion category is a gift that I got from one of my old friends, Christina. This is a wallet from Francesca's. It's like made of this very, I'm getting glitter all over it, luxurious feeling suede. It has a handle, the tassel, the gold features. But the nice thing about this wallet is that it actually charges my phone. That's the charger right there. It has a separate compartment that you would put your phone in. Of course, all these sides for like your driver's license and your credit cards. And then I actually keep in the zipper compartment the cord that you would use to charge, which is right here. This inserts into the charge port. And then here are the two adapters for Android, which is me, and for iPhone. So, absolutely do love this thing. If I could find it and link it down below, or at least link if Francesca's has a website. Because I know I've seen a store when I was in Virginia and in DC. So, I don't know like how prevalent Francesca's is in the States. But whatever I find, I will link down below. It's expensive as hell, and I hate to say that it's almost empty and I'm going to have to repurchase, but it's the Sunday Riley Luna Oil. Yes, an oil for my oily skin. This stuff has completely transformed my skin. If you're a subscriber of mine and it's blue, I don't know if you can tell it's blue, you would know that I was experiencing some really horrible breakouts between October and up until January. Like, my skin was the worst that it's been in forever. And this oil, it has retinoid oil. It's supposed to help with pores and wrinkles and the whole texture of the skin. Promotes even-toned skin, uneven texture, age spots, dryness, dullness. It just has a lot of fancy stuff in it, in which you'll see results after 4 weeks. I know I saw a change in my skin within days, like some of the acne that I had on my cheeks and on my chin and my jawline was like healing within a few days. And I would have to say, this is the best that my skin's been in a while. You probably can't really tell. I do have, unfortunately, some hyperpigmentation acne scarring, but my texture is so much better. Of course, I do have a couple of live raised zits on my cheeks due to my own stupidity of falling asleep with my makeup on. But this stuff helped my skin. It is so expensive, but it's a sleeping night oil, so you put this on at night. I will be repurchasing this, and it has retinol in it. And I'm actually curious about an oil that's specifically for oily skin. I will probably be trying that one soon. Oh no, I left something out in the fashion category. Two things I actually don't have to show, simply because I have them packed up somewhere because I am going on vacation next week. But it's the fashion brand Rebecca Minkoff. I actually own now two handbags from her, in which I will show off really soon in the Real Real video that I plan on doing. I just feel like it's a classic, but yet fashion forward brand. Like, her purses are very distinct. I've had people recognize the first bag I have, which is like one of her Speedy bags. I've had people recognize it, like complete strangers when I'm walking through stores. I've only purchased purses from her. I don't know if I'll ever branch out like with her clothing or anything like that. The next two things are not very fun subjects per se, but they fall into a very adult category, finances. The first one is it actually has become my primary bank account. If you're interested in giving it a try or getting like an invitation from me, you can leave me a comment or send me a message or something with your email. If I don't have like a link that I don't think I have a referral link or anything like that. Whatever I can find, whatever information, I can link it down below. But it's an online bank called Chime. Now, I do actually have, technically I have three bank accounts, or I do my banking at three different institutions, with one being a local one. But it's an online bank that's linked with credit unions. So if you have any credit unions in your area, you can always use their ATMs. The app for the bank system actually tells you where you can get cash back or use an ATM and not get charged any fees. I basically have switched over my payroll where I get my paychecks from my real job deposited to my new Chime banking account. Some great perks is that you automatically get notifications for whenever you slide your debit card or take money out of the ATM. Now, of course, with any bank account, you can set up like text notifications. With Chime, it's automatic. It comes to your phone like a Facebook notification, which I love. Heaven forbid if my card's ever stolen, I will know immediately when someone tries to use it. To get in contact with their customer service is very interactive, very quick, and you basically use the app and the messaging system, which I think is pretty cool. But the two things that sucked me in was, one, the savings account that I have with them. It basically rounds up every dollar that I spend with my debit card and it puts that change to the savings account. Well, listen to this. Chime every Friday will total out what your savings, like what the amount of the savings that's gone to your savings account from your roundups, and it gives you a 10% bonus every Friday. And of course, when you invite people to open accounts with them, they have like referral bonuses and stuff like that. But what bank gives you a 10% bonus on anything? But the other thing that really sucked me in was the promise, and if you go to the website, you'll see this, is that if you get a direct deposit from your workplace, Chime pays you up to 2 days early. So, you know, you get your paycheck every Friday or every 2 weeks. Yes, my paycheck actually gets direct deposited on the Wednesday before my payday, so Chime, absolutely love it. I actually had my first issue where one of my bills posted twice to my account. Now it also involved that company working with my bank, but you know, my money was credited back to my account like within a couple of days, so absolutely love it. Yeah, I love getting paid 2 days earlier than the rest of my coworkers. And then that 10% bonus every Friday that goes to my savings. Love it. The next thing, actually, just because I suck at savings, I currently have four savings accounts, you guys, at four different institutions, is Digit Savings. Sounds kind of like not trusting, but I've been using it for almost a year now. It's a savings account that basically links to your main checking account, which I have it linked to one of my checking accounts, and it analyzes your spending. And what it does, just because I don't write every charge down in my checkbook, I just have a roundabout idea of what my balance is. It basically analyzes your savings and it basically debits your account. It could be 17 cents here. If your balance is really high, it might be $10 there. but it basically moves it to a savings account. They have an awesome app that emails you every morning what your checking account balance is. And then you can also check what your digit savings account. I know with digit savings, I'm horrible. I can never save money. But with my digit savings account, and I had this before my Chime, within 4 weeks, I had saved over $100 due to it just taking like little micro amounts out of my checking account. And they promise to never throw your account in the negative or anything like that. Now, if you ever need the money, all you have to do is a digit analyst like texts you and you can save it in your phone. And that's the person that texts you every morning with your checking account balance and lets you know what your recent charges are. You can basically text this person, withdraw or transfer, and it communicates back with you immediately. Because I think it might be automated, but it's pretty advanced. And so let's say if you need to like take out that $100, you can do it all by texting. And if you do it before a certain time, I think it's like before 5 p.m. or something like that, it goes back into your checking account the next day. So Digit Savings, don't know if they have a referral program, but if they do, I'll link it below, whatever information. Chime and Digit, I'm thankful for both. The next thing is a memory that you probably won't be able to see for a while just because I'm so behind with my vlogs. But I went to, if you follow me on Instagram or Snapchat, which if you don't, you should. We recently went and visited an old college friend that lives in Indiana. And of course, while I was up there. Now Snapchat, I do post in real time. My Instagram, I'm actually still just posting things now from that trip. But I absolutely loved it. I went to Aurora, Indiana, and then I went to Westchester in Mason, Ohio, and I went to Cincinnati. Just loved being in a different atmosphere, but definitely an absolutely good memory. I'm still uploading pictures to my Instagram from that trip, so you can check them out on there. Of course, I did vlog while I was up there, but that probably won't be uploaded until like 2019. The thing that connects the two things would be the Scentbird monthly subscription. If you're interested, I'll put my link down below. There might be a promo code where you can save some money. If I have one, I'll put it down below. But it's $14.95 a month. Basically, you get a travel vial of different perfumes or colognes that you can pick out in advance. And for indecisive people like me, people that, you know, are kind of OCD and I have to like use up one perfume at a time, this has been very convenient. I've tried perfumes that I've been curious about through this program and found new loves. The Scentbird program reintroduced me to a favorite that smells awesome on me, the Lancôme Olivier Belle. Love that fragrance. But then it also introduced me to the Tom Ford Velvet Orchid. I can never afford a full-size bottle, all that stuff. I'll put up the price. But this Scentbird program allowed me to try it, which I realized I love it, and I probably will only try it through the $14.95. But Scentbird sounds weird, but it's an awesome program, and I know they recently came out with makeup, like the Deck of Scarlet palettes, which I don't know if I'm going to rejoin that, because I just have way too much makeup. But definitely check it out if you're curious. I swear you will love it. I got three nail polishes to show you. This is they're all by Julep, by the way. This is a Stardust finish, and it's called Elsa. It kind of dries to like a matte, bumpy, glittery finish, which I know sounds really strange. But when I wore this color, I got a lot of compliments. Next color that I wore was this one called Joss, which is basically almost like a galaxy greenish purple color. The last one I currently have on, unfortunately, I just chipped one of these nails. This color is Mariah, which is a beautiful purple color, and you can see it on my nails now. The song that you heard throughout this video and in my last few videos is a house mix done by this internet artist of the Charlie Puth and whatever is that, Puth? And Selena Gomez song, We Don't Talk Anymore. You're probably going to be hearing this song for like the next few weeks just because I love it so much. And this is it for my monthly favorites. If you have any January favorites that you'd like to share with me, leave them in a comment below. And that's it. Again, this is Rose, and thank you so much for watching this crap. Everything that I can link down below, I will. And if you found this at all helpful or entertaining, then please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe, become part of my random family. And don't forget to click that bell for notifications. And until next time, I hope you all have a great day. You'll be seeing me again, hopefully, very soon. Bye.